Okay, I figured I'd do a little video on this rifle again, do a little better video. I got two or three on this. I got a couple shooting videos of it. I was sighting it in, sort of, kinda. And I got one where it was apart, and I was showing some of the, and then like details of how the, like the drum and the that kind of stuff is, and the breech plug and stuff, kind of how that works or how it looks inside. So anyway, this is my Spanish. It's like hunker or something like that, I guess it's pronounced, because the J would be an H in Spanish, but it looks like junker. But they were sold under quite a few different names, like CBA, and I think like the Traditions, the muzzleloaders now are basically the same gun. They got like the Kentucky ones with the like the two-piece stock with the brass spacer thing. You can get them in cap lock like this or flint lock, and they're all pretty much the same. They're all made in Spain. They're all like, this one's a 45, and it's 1/66 twist, and it's 33-inch barrel, like octagon barrel, so it's basically made for shooting round ball. They're overall a decent gun. They're sort of a, I don't know, sort of entry level muzzleloader, I guess. They work okay. Some of them, they seem like they have trouble. They get plugged up as you shoot them. The fouling gets jammed up in here, and they can have misfires and stuff. But I don't know if 2F causes that more issue with that, or like 3F can flow better and get down in here and everything. Where 2F might sort of, I don't know, it just doesn't seem to work as well. And with the 45, 3F is probably preferable anyway. So, but it's it's a full stocked rifle, the two pieces. The forward part is pinned on. You can see there's one there, another pin there, and then the nose cap is screwed to the barrel. That sort of holds that on. But you can see this one has got a gap, like the nose cap actually should be back further. So I think this was a kit gun, and it just wasn't put together very well. And then there's the thimbles for the hold the ramrod, and I think there's screws that come from the back that hold them on. And one here, and then you got your brass thing, and then there's like pins that come out, go in both sides, and then you got your normal little lock, your drum, your nipple, pretty standard. Just got the single trigger. I don't think this lock, you accept a set trigger. I don't think it does anyway. And you got your tang screw, so you more or less got to take that out, take the nose cap off, and I think you can easily pull the pieces apart. But you usually take the pins. I usually just take the push the pins out to take the forward wood off the thing when you're cleaning it. So it's easy to stick the whole thing in a bucket of soapy water and stuff like that when I clean the thing. So your brass trigger guard, and you get kind of a pistol grip kind of thing built into it. And you can see it's quite small, which is sort of normal for the sort of Kentucky type kind of rifles. They're really small, thin stocks on them. You got a crescent butt plate, and it's all brass, and then it's got this piece, and then there's like the toe plate. And I think it's beechwood that it's made out of, which I don't know, it kind of looks like approximates maple, I guess, the color. So it's fairly light wood. I don't usually like a darker wood on a stock, but it's all right, I guess. But then you get some little bit of markings on the side here. Black powder only, hunker or junker, your serial number, and then Spain. That's pretty much it. I don't think there's anything underneath. Like on my little, I had a CVA 50 caliber years ago, and it was basically the same lock and everything, barrel. It just was 50 caliber, and it was like the, what was it, Mountain carbine or Mountain, I forget what it was really called, but it had, you know, CVA written on it. And I think the serial number actually, I think the date was part of the serial number. This one it doesn't, but you know, it was probably made in the 80s or something or other. It was 50 caliber, and it had a 24 inch barrel and a sort of a half stock thing. And I think it was one in 48 twist, I believe, because I'd shot like the Lee real bullets out of it, and it seemed to work okay. But it seemed to work okay, but I got rid of it years ago. But it was like, I don't know what the steel is in these barrels, but they seem to like rust really fast when you're trying to clean them. Like if you don't get them dried out like right fast, they seem to like sort of flash rust kind of thing. But it seemed to do it a lot quicker than like the Vestarm or the Lyman or any of the other, pretty much, you know, Thompson Center or something, or I don't know, or maybe it's just all the guns I ever had that were these type were already had like sort of dark grooves on them, so maybe it was just there was already rust there or something, so they just sort of, anyway. This one's got a sort of okay-ish barrel. It's like it's the grooves are a little bit, got, you know, like sort of micro pitting or whatever you want to call it, like sort of a little bit of somebody didn't clean it the best one time or something. But I guess that's kind of the you know, the cheap guns, a lot of times they don't get treated very well and stuff. But you can see like there's a little bit of pitting and stuff around there. If it'll actually focus, which it doesn't want to. Oh, there it goes. It gets kind of yucky around here and stuff, but anyway, it's not too bad. You just, you know, scrub the barrel out, but it seems to shoot fairly accurately. It still, for me, it shoots low, so I'm gonna have to do something with the front sight. It's sort of filed down fairly short, like it's almost like I should have a sight that's lower than that again, but anyway, we'll mess with that. So I think I might do a bit of a stress test on it this summer to see if it can get through 30 shots or 20 shots without it having hang fires or getting plugged up or anything, just to see if it's, you know, maybe taking on a woods walk or a rendezvous or something would have issues with it. So anyway, I figured I'd do a little video on it. Kind of, they're not bad little gun. You can get them for like super cheap, and there's like tons of them around, so they're fairly easy to find parts for. So that's kind of nice. So if you need like springs or locks or, you know, lock parts and stuff, then and the sights and things are, they seem to be fairly common. So because I think there's like these fixed sights like this, but then there was one, I don't know if it was on these ones or the CVA ones, but they had like a little one that came out and had a screw that you could adjust it up and down. Had a little bit more adjustment, but fixed sights are fairly good for guns like this, because round ball guns are fairly short range, because it, you know, like whatever the velocity is at muzzle, it's like by 100 yards it loses like almost like half the velocity, or like they slow down like ridiculously fast. So it's sort of a thing where you sight it in with the fixed sights at like 50 yards and then call it a day. And plus they don't get out of adjustment and stuff. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you later.